students, today we are going to discuss about lag insect cultivation. It is part of MSc Zoology 4 semester elective group C entomology, medical and applied entomology. In the coming lecture we are going to discuss about a very important natural resource, lag. What is the source of lag, how lag is obtained, how insects and forests are playing important role in lag culture, how can be lag culture be important for our Indian economy and as a startup employment for youth. Insects provide us very valuable services and to environment in different types of ways. They produce different useful substances such as honey, wax, dye, shellac, silk, etc. Honeybees, silkworms, Lacifolia, coccineal bugs, etc. are the best examples of semi-domesticated insects which are artificially bred by human beings for the sake of different commercial products. Now let us know what actually lag cultivation is. Lag cultivation is the scientific management of lag insect to produce high amount and good quality of lag. Lag is one of the most valuable natural gift to man. It is secreted by a tiny insect, Lacifolia. It is an exclusively material which is only animal origin resin. Lag is the scarlet resinous secretion of the insect Lacifolia. Actually, the word lag derives from the Sanskrit word laksh, which means lakh or hundred or thousand, because lakh is obtained from numerous insects. It is known in our India from ancient times. Actually, lag insect is a parasite which lives on trees, different types of trees or host trees, from central India to Burma and China. During Vedic period, lakh was known as laksha. The great Indian epic Mahabharata also mentions about the incident of lakshagra, an inflammable house of lag constructed by Kauravas to burn their great enemy Pandavas. The method of lag extraction is also mentioned in Vinaya text of Buddhist. In our India, the first institute for the systematic research on lag was established in 1924, which is known as Indian Lag Research Institute. And now from September 2007, it is known as Indian Institute of Natural Resins and Gums. Lag culture is the main source of livelihood of poor and tribal people which lives in forest and sub-forest areas. Lag is assumed as an eco-friendly, biodegradable and self-sustaining natural material. Lag culture can also help in ecosystem development as well as in our high economic returns. Now we will discuss about the taxonomic position. The lag insect belongs to phylum Orthopoda, class Insecta, order Hemiptera, suborder Homoptera. It belongs to family Lacifaridae. The genus is known as Lacifer and species is Laca. We are going to discuss about Lacifer Laca. Then first we will discuss about habit and habitat. Where are they actually present? The lag insects are distributed in Southeast and Asian countries like India, Thailand, Malaya, Laos, Myanmar, China, etc. But in India and Thailand, there are the main lag cultivation producing area are present. India has a prime position in lag culture. India covers about 90% of lag produced from the different states of Bihar, Jharkhand, West Bengal, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Maharashtra, Orissa, Andhra Pradesh, Punjab, Rajasthan, Mysore, Gujarat, Mirzapur and Uttar Pradesh. Now we will discuss about different host plants of lag insect. Lag insect grows on twigs of different types of host plant species. Some of the main species are Butea monosperma, which is known as Palash, Zizipus, which is known as Bear, Sclicera oleosa, which is known as Kusum, Acacia catechu, which is known as Khair. Now, insect morphology. Leg insect is reddish in appearance, having reduced eyes and antenna. Thorax bears a pair of hyaline wings. Male is smaller in length in comparison to female. Have a pyriform body. The body division, head, thorax and abdomen are not clearly distinct. Antenna and legs are reduced or in degenerated form. Wings are absent. Leg insect is a minute crawling hemipteran scale insect which grows and secretes resinous leg from the body. Its body get covered with this structure called as cell, which is made up of resinous secretion called as leg. The main purpose of the cell is protection. Now we are going to discuss about life cycle of leg insect. Leg insect life cycle consists of main stages, egg, nymph, instars, pupa and adult. Leg shows oviparous reproduction. Life cycle is completed approximately in 6 months. Female lays 200 to 500 eggs. These eggs are developed inside the body. Before hatching, they are well developed. The first instar is crimson red in color. The first nymphal stage is called as crawler. The process of emergence of nymph is called as swarming. It lasts for 5 weeks. The nymphs crawl in various branches of their host trees and settled in 200 to 300 per inch. At this stage, male nymphs both lived on the sap of the plants because they have a sucking type of mouthparts. The nymph molt 3 times. They enclose themselves into resinous secretion cell. After first molting, appendages, eye of both male and female nymphs are degenerated. After 8 weeks approximate, male and female larva attain sexual maturity. They reproduce and again. Each instar is dependent on different factors like temperature, humidity and host plants. The male insect completely transfers into another form. It loses its proboscis and develops antenna, legs and single pair of wings. The male lives in a slipper-shaped brood cell, which having an exit operculum through which it emerges out. The adult male is winged and moves towards another females to fertilize them. The female retains her mouthparts but is without wings, eyes or appendages. The brood cell of female is round and bigger. It consists of developing embryos inside the brood cells. The female after 14 weeks reduces in size with 2 yellow spots appeared at the rear end of the cell. The female oviposits a large number of eggs in a body space called as ovisac. The ovisac appears orangish due to crimson fluid filled inside the body. This is leg dye. The eggs hatches, larva emerges and the whole process begins all over again. Now we will discuss about host plant management. There are mainly 2 ways for the cultivation of host plants. First one is natural way. The host plants are grown in their natural way. Leg culturalists have to protect and take care for the proper growth of the plants. The another way is artificial systematic plantation of the host plants is done on particular piece of land, and proper care of plants is done by providing them artificially natural conditions, proper irrigation, artificial manure, proper protection of the field. Now we will discuss about 2 strains, Kusumi strain and Rangini strain. Kusumi strain is grown on Kusum host plant. Rangini strain is grown on other host plants except Kusum. Their names are given on the base of Indian Hindu month calendar. In case of Kusumi strain, there are 2 crops, Jethvi and Aghani. in case of Rangini, True Crops, Kartiki and Baishaki. If we talk about Kusumi strain, the lack of Kusumi crop is harvested after maturing, but in case of Rangini strain, the lack of Rangini crop is harvested in immature stage. If we talk about the production, 10% of lakh production is contributed by Kusumi crops and other 90% of the lakh production is contributed by Rangini strain. If we compare the quality of both strains, the Kusumi crop is considered a superior quality of resin. Now we will discuss about lakh cultivation, the method of cultivation. The main steps involved in the cultivation of lakh are pruning, which means removing the dead and diseased part of the plant, cutting off them. Inoculation means start of growth of lakh insect on the particular host plant. Harvesting means taking the lakh from the insect. And last, proper pest management. First step in the lakh cultivation is pruning. Pruning means removal of old, weak and diseased wicks. It is the similar step as we talk about the agriculture. The seed sowing is a very important step in initiation of agriculture. Similarly, host plants are first pruning, and the all success and the growth of lakh insect depends on the pruning. Pruning should be done with the different sharp instruments like a scatware, pruning saw and pruning knife, etc. In palace tree, we can start the production of lakh at the age of 8 to 10 years. One thing should be important, that there should be no excessive pruning in order to maintain the good health and strength of the tree. Branches exceeding 2 inch in diameter should not be cut, and the most satisfactory and good results are obtained by cutting the thickness approximate 1 to 2 inch in diameter, and thin branches under 1/2 inch diameter should be removed. Normally the time of pruning is Jan to Feb and April to May. If we talk about the propagation of lakh insect, it is the second step, which is also called as inoculation. Propagation of lakh insects means the process of spreading of lakh insect on the same or different host plants. Propagation can be done by the process of inoculation of newly hatched nymphs of the lakh insect. Inoculation is the method by which the lakh insects are produced on a host plants. Inoculation can be done in the two ways, naturally and artificially. In natural way, it is a very simple and common process. The swarm nymphs naturally infect the host plant again. But in this case, the results are not good. The host plant becomes weak by the same again and again inoculation. It cannot get proper nutrition. The second method of inoculation is artificial. Artificial inoculation, as the name indicates, that it is done by man artificially. The main idea behind the artificial is to check the various limitations of natural inoculation. In this method, the host plants are first of all pruned in their pruning season, Jan or June, and after this, the brood twigs are tied with the fresh tree twigs, and the nymphs swarm from brood and migrate to the tender and succulent twigs, and they start feeding on them with their piercing and sucking mouth parts. And after this, the swarming stage comes, and after swarming, the brood twigs are removed from the host plants. Now we will discuss about the next step of the lakh cultivation, harvesting or cropping. The following point should be kept in mind before we are going to do our harvesting of the lakh crops. Lakh crop can only obtained after maturation. There should be no premature cutting of the lakh. It can reduce the quality of lakh, or it can affect the female lakh if she is removed, not get proper nutrition from host plant. It can result in weakness and unhealthy progeny will be obtained. All diseased and dead plants, dead plant parts should be cut off. Now next part is leg crop management. The following points should be carefully followed for the leg crop management by the cultivators. Leg crop under field cultivation is monitored regularly for proper checking of the infestation of enemy insects, predatory animals, fungus, etc. Pest management should be done from time to time. It can depend upon the environmental condition. Fully mature and healthy brood leg should be free from pests. The quantity of brood leg used usually depends on the size of tree. For example, in case of palas tree, 300 grams, and if we talk about small trees, so it can give about 1 kg of leg is obtained. Tying of the brood leg stick should be done securely on the upper surface of branches. Sometimes due to bad weather, swarming of nymphs from brood is prevented. Hence, the room storing facility should be available so that we can moderately heat our brood leg sticks to initiate for swarming. Generally, the cultivation of kusumi is in Rangini area and vice versa should be avoided. If we talk about different types of leg, this is very important topic. You should keep in mind different types of leg. Airy leg, it is immature leg harvested from the host plants. Stick leg, it is a matured leg harvested in the form of a stick from host plants. Seed leg, it is obtained after removing and washing the leg from the stick. Dust leg, it is obtained after grinding seed leg. Shell leg, it is important and very important. It is a commercial leg prepared after heating and processing the seed leg and dust leg. Processing of leg. Processing of leg, simple raw leg into commercial leg is summarized in the following step. First, scraped leg is grinded into stone mill. Then this grinded leg is repeatedly washed with cold water to remove the dust, dirt and other useless particles. Then leg is exposed to sun for drying. This is called as seed leg. Now the seed leg is subjected to melt by heating. Different colors and other chemicals are added during melting. And finally, the melted leg is sieved through cloth and molded in desired shape as per as our requirement. This is called as shellac. If we talk about leg composition, the major component of the stick leg is the resin. It occupies 70-80% of the total leg composition. The resin can be fractioned into two parts, soft and hard components. The soft resin consists of free acids and neutral materials including the yellow dye, erythrolacin, while hard resin consists of equivalent amounts of eluritic acid. This is an isomer of eluritic acid and lacolic lacton. The other components of the leg are red dye, sugars, proteins and soluble salts, wax, sand, woody matter, insect bodies, etc. And also volatile oil is present in small amount. Now we will talk about shellac. Actually, what is shellac? Shellac is, as we discussed previously, shellac is commercial leg. It is natural, non-toxic, hard, tough, amorphous, brittle, physiologically harmless and edible resin. It is a commercial product which have extraordinary properties. It is used as a thermoplastic. It is used in different field of food industry. It is a UV resistant. It have excellent dielectric properties. Shellac is a powerful bonding material with a low thermal conductivity. It have an excellent adhesion to wide variety of surfaces and have a high glossy and hardness strength property. Now we will discuss about the different uses of leg. Leg is a very important commercial product and it is used in our very different types of daily life products. We will discuss about some important points. The leg is used as a filling material in the different types of ornaments by jewelers, It is used in different edible products like fruit coatings, citrus fruits, apple, different types of glazing agents in sweets, chocolates, etc. It is used in preparation of toys, bangles, and it is used in different types of cosmetic products. Lac is used in coating of medicinal tablets. It is used in manufacturing of photographical material, lithographic ink, and for stiffening and other material. Now we will discuss about lac culture in relation to our country India. India has a very great potential for the lac culture. Lac culture provides Indian foreign exchange of approximately 90 crores of rupees per annum approximately. Lac culture provides different part-time occupation to 5 million cultivators approximately. Government is doing very different research and different proposal for development of lac culture. Lac culture is very important in aspect for our Indian economy. India is a major lac producing country of the world. It produces approximately 18,000 metric tons of unrefined raw lac annually. About 85% of the country's production is exported to various countries. USA, Germany, and Egypt are some of the major lac importing countries of the world. If we talk about India, the major important areas of lac production are Bihar, Madhya Pradesh, Assam, Orissa, Uttar Pradesh. Some small quantity of lac are also produced at Punjab, Karnataka, and Tamil Nadu. Indian Lac Research Institute, sub branch of ICAR, Namkum Ranchi, which is now known as Indian Institute of Natural Resin and Gums, has developed various advanced technologies and management methods for lac cultivation. Now we will discuss about different types of problems related to our lac industry. In this topic, we will discuss about different types of lac enemies. First, insects. Insects cause a great damage to our lac crop. Insects are a serious and damaging pest and can reduce up to 30 to 40% of our lac yield. Insect can damage the lac crop in two ways. First one is as a parasite. As a parasite, insect can reduce up to 5 to 10%. As parasites, lac insect population up to 5 to 10% are parasitized and killed by insect parasites. Some parasite insect species examples are from family Calcidioidea from order Hymenoptera, Perichthrodrinus clavicornis, Erinaceratus davidsi, Tachardia fagus, Eupelmus tetrasticus. These insect pests lay their eggs in the lac cell, and their young larval stage or grubs start feeding on lac insect within the cell, and they reduce their yield and population. Second one is insect pests as predators. These predators can cause major damage up to 35% to lac crop. There are numerous predators on lac insect. The three main ones are Chrysopa species, it is known as lac wing fly from order Diptera, Eublema amabilis, this is white lac moth. It is a disastrous pest or predator for lac culture. Holocerca pulveria, it is a black lac moth from order Lepidoptera. Now we will discuss about control measures for insect enemies of lac. Before inoculation, proper brood lac should be observed. It should be healthy and pest free. The enclosing of brood lac for inoculation is covered in 60 to 80 mesh wire gauze baskets to reduce pest infestation or pest damage. The twigs for inoculation should be cut just after swarming to get healthy brood. scraping of leg from twigs immediately after harvesting is done, and killing larvae and pupa of the pest by burning, crushing, drowning, or by fumigation with carbon bisulfide before storage. Infected stick leg should be destroyed along with the predators and pests. Now the other problem in the leg culture are vertebrate enemies. Some important vertebrate enemies like squirrels, rats, monkeys, they can cause damage up to 50% of total leg yield. Squirrels usually damage in daytime, while the rats are nocturnal, they can cause damage during nighttime. When the crop is at maturity stage, these pests gnaw the mature leg incrustation on the tree, and the brood leg tied on the trees for inoculation. They consume the fully grown leg female insect with the plenty of eggs inside them. The vertebrate monkey can also cause some damage to leg incrustation. It is very difficult to control the vertebrate enemies of leg insects. Some methods are to control these vertebrate pests are scaring these animals or poisoning them, or keep attention on the leg culture. Dear students, so in this lecture today we learned about the various aspects of leg culture. If we talk about our India country, India has very great potential for the leg culture, and we can improve this leg culture by different types of management techniques and different advanced technology. Leg is one of the most valuable natural gift to man. It is only animal resin which is produced from animal. So leg culture is very important for our Indian economy. Thank you.